More balls than Professor Oak. Welcome to Wired and Witty's podcast.
Welcome to another episode of Wired.
Witty.
And everything else podcast. Sorry, we didn't do one. Well, we did one last week, but the recording got...
fucked up.
Yeah, so... Oh well, it happens, and so we're coming back after like a good week break with I think quite a few things to talk about. But like I said, at the start of the new year, we're gonna do every podcast with a shout out of a YouTuber that's been supportive of us or that we seek
Jet.
Okay,
you spilled some. My
oh shit. she's that excited about shouting out this person that she spilled her coffee.
Yeah.
So yeah, we do seek inspiration from a lot of other YouTubers out there, and we do like the support we see from a few. So yeah. Sasha, who are we shouting out this week?
One sec.
Are you covered in coffee?
That might be.
Oh man.
Hold on. I hand them up and then I fucking just hold on.
Yeah.
One quick. Okay. All right.
All right. We good?
Yeah. Okay. Sorry. It's it's Crimson Studios. Yay.
Crimson Studios. Hello, Crimson Studios.
Hello, Crimson Studios. So it's I think I don't know if they're brothers. I'm not sure.
Oh no.
They might be brothers, or okay. They might just be best friends. But it's they do comedy. And they actually reached out to me on Twitter, and they're really nice guys. You should check out their channel. We'll put a link in the description. They're pretty funny, and they actually were watching our Resident Evil 6 playthrough. They commented a couple of times, and they're really cool guys. They actually get their mom and dad to be in some of their videos, and it's pretty hilarious. I like that. I like that.
That's cute. I'll have to go and check some of their videos. I do, but this is how I learn about new YouTube channels from time to time. So I'm gonna go check out Crimson Studios. And I ask you guys too, and if you guys like them, make sure you drop a subscribe and tell them Wired and Witty sent you. And so cool. Thanks for the support, Crimson Studios.
Yeah.
All right, so moving on to some news, I guess you could say that has transpired this week. The first thing I'd like to talk about is that Netflix has picked up to do a Castlevania.
I saw that
series. That sounds really. That could be either really cool or really, really bad.
I mean, I don't.
I like Castlevania.
Yeah, I like Castlevania. I mean, the Castlevania 1, awesome. Castlevania 2, not so great. Castlevania 3, okay. Castlevania for the 64, fucking awful. The new one that got put out for PlayStation? PlayStation 1 or 2?
There's been a bunch of them. Like Symphony of Night, I think, is kind of like everybody's go-to Castlevania, which was
really
a PS1 title to start, anyways, when it was first released. And then, it just has a bunch of games. I know they tried to be a little bit like God of War in their last couple, and albeit not bad games. I like the Patrick Stewart voiceover in one of them. You know, it's still such a cool atmosphere and world where I think they have a lot to I think that if done by the right writers and people, it could be really, really well or great.
Yeah, I mean, we'll see. Unless I have a feeling it's going to turn out to be like maybe on accident or on purpose, like Vampire Diaries.
I hope not.
I know.
Well, anyways, I saw that. What caught your eye this week?
Ben Affleck.
Oh, what happened now?
Well, okay, so we didn't release this podcast because on the last podcast we talked about how Ben Affleck didn't want people talking about Batman because stop asking him about Batman. And we got
a little heated. A little heated.
A little heated. Some things were said.
I think I recall a couple things. Okay, so, you know, this is directed at Mr. Affleck, who's never going to listen to this.
Yeah, of course.
So, Mr. Affleck, you got to understand the reason why people kind of, like, get uppity about Batman and shit like that, because a lot of them, like me, grew up with Batman, and kind of is like their favorite hero sort of thing, or at least one of them, and is kind of a badass in...
Yeah, I'm sorry.
I mean, Ben Affleck, I've seen some great movies from him, and he's a good actor and even an awesome director. But, dude, you can't be mad at people for being like, yo, so what's going on with Batman?
Yeah, I mean, how long ago was Batman versus Superman?
About a year and a half, I want to say.
Normally, they would already be talking about around now. All right, so you took on this project. What are you going to do? And he's getting, like, he always, I don't know. I've read that there are a couple of things going on with the script. He completely threw away the script. And basically he's been quoted in saying, and this is an interview that he did recently, like, in January. It's not a set thing, and there's no script. If it doesn't come together in a way I think is really great, I'm not going to do it.
Didn't he sign a contract, though, to be, like, in, like, six or seven different Batman movies, or at least, like, movies in general that involve Batman? Because you would think, like, because Justice League is coming around the corner, you would think that they would already be almost ready to shoot Batman, to where... sometime shortly after Justice League, like maybe the next year, Batman standalone would be coming out to kind of expound upon that.
Yeah.
And I did see in like an interesting video the other day of like why Marvel movies are doing a lot better than DC is because they took time to flesh out everybody's like backstory, and then basically now you have like a colliding of worlds whenever they all meet in like the Avengers or the Civil Wars.
Yep.
Shit like that where DC is not really doing that. They're trying to like speed up the process.
Yeah, everything. Yeah, trying to get you, to connect with the characters, and like we haven't had enough time. We haven't had enough time with Superman. We had one movie with Superman. We had no movie with Wonder Woman. We have no movie with Aquaman. No movie with the Flash. And then you're just sort of doing the superhero get together thing, and we're all supposed to just be like, oh yeah, I'm excited to see how the Flash is going to interact with, Aquaman, or I'm excited, like, I don't know what's going
to
happen.
I think they might be trying to do it backwards, and it may pay off of them in the end, like, they're going to try to explain their backstories and coming together in the Justice League.
Yeah.
And then maybe branch off to do standalones, which I don't see a problem with, but it's like... it's one of those things, like, whenever you watch the Avengers in a movie theater and, like Ant-Man shows up, everyone's like, ah!
Yeah!
And then Flash shows up in, like, Suicide Squad, and, like, everyone's like, is that Flash?
Is that Flash? Like, yeah.
So you don't have this big, like, oh my god, it's Flash! Yeah. Holy shit!
Cause, I know.
You know, there just hasn't been a standalone thing for them. So, yeah, I mean, hopefully they don't fuck it up too bad. I don't know. I don't see them fucking up any worse than they already have been. So,
I just
think the Batman versus Superman should have been written to be in two parts. I think it would have made a lot more sense.
It really should have.
At the same time,
the ending felt rushed.
Yeah, and at the same time, like they spent a lot of. From my understanding, like whenever they had everything together, it was like 4.5 freaking hours. If you would have wrote it and directed it a little bit to where it would have been a two-parter, it probably would have been a little better.
Yeah. I mean, everyone does that. I mean, like, when you have a huge story like Harry Potter. They broke it, especially the last part.
Yeah.
They broke it up into two parts.
Hunger Games.
The Hunger Games broke it up into two parts. I mean, there's nothing wrong with that.
No. And it's kind of a big movie to do that, not to mention you're basically... if the first one's, successful, the second one, obviously.
It will be, because everyone wants to see the conclusion.
So, we'll see. I mean, it's already underway, I guess you could say. And the thing is, I would hope that Affleck being such great friends with Kevin Smith, I think Kevin Smith is a really good writer. He's a really good director as well. I think he could offer a lot to Affleck. If he's not already utilizing Kevin Smith to help him with these projects, I think he should consider it. Because, he's a huge comic book nerd and would probably give Affleck such a great direction to go with the character. And I think it would just be a dream of Kevin Smith to do that. Now, I know, like, Kevin Smith does do some of the DC superhero shows like Arrow, and I think he's directed a few episodes here and there on those.
Yeah, and those do okay.
Yeah, so, it would make sense if he would be brought into the fold. If not, I mean, for all I know, he already is.
Well, the big update that's been released is that... in January 30th, he released a statement stating that he's going to be stepping down as director of the Batman. So he's not doing the direct. They're looking for a new director. So they were planning on release in 2018, but now it looks like, since Affleck is not so committed to the project, it might be 2019.
Ooh.
So yeah.
Well, yeah. You know what that tells me though. Just
it's not happening.
No. Okay. I think it very well could. I think it's also a damage control sort of thing where, if the movie does suck, Affleck's not to blame.
Yeah, that's true.
He's just like, I just play the role. The director and the writers told me what to do.
Yeah.
I just played it. So, and I think that that's what that's telling me. I could be wrong. For all I know, he's overworked and all that shit.
No, I... With what? Gone Girl 2.
Well, I know he did The Accountant, and I think he's got a couple of... I don't know. Pull him up on IMDb, and we'll see what he's got going on currently. But, I think that's what that tells me, is just like, he doesn't want to be held responsible if the movie's bad.
And here's the thing, is that like a lot of like insiders say that he was unhappy with how Batman versus Super Saiyan. versus Superman was received, and like, quote, he felt humiliated after spending so much of the press tour saying how much better this film would be than Daredevil. And it wasn't.
So, yeah, look at that. He looks like he's got a lot of projects going on, does he not?
Yeah, something called Incorporated is a TV series. Never heard of it. Which was in 2016, so that's a long gone. There's a cat butt in my face. There's another TV movie called Thirst. The Batman, which has no date next to it anymore. Justice League and Witness for the Prosecution, which is in 2018.
I mean, I know he tries to stay busy, but I don't know what the fuck's going on. Anyways, enough talking about Batfleck. Yeah. I mean, I kind of saw it coming. He was going to fuck it up, and I think he's going to continue to do it, so,
yeah.
Which sucks. I don't think he's the worst Batman by any means, but I think, like you said, he's just, I think he's overwhelmed by it.
Yeah, I think he didn't think through what was going to happen when he took on that kind of project. But, you know, that would be stupid not to think about that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Looks like John Wick 2 is getting some great reviews.
Oh, yeah. I'm excited.
Yeah.
Are we going to go see it together? Because I know you didn't see the last one with me because of the dog thing.
Possibly. I'm not sure exactly what I'm up to this weekend. Were you going to go this weekend and see it?
Maybe. I was thinking we could get Jen in on Sunday or something, maybe.
Maybe.
But we'll see.
Yeah, we'll see.
I'm bringing a
That's
Christmas
actually not
tree
a bad idea.
Saturday,
we could probably bring the sound engineer with us.
Yeah.
You
think she'll like that type of movie?
She doesn't really watch movies. Who cares? That's the thing. She just does sound. She just does sound things.
Yeah, she'll just come along and.
in other news too, the Super Bowl was actually a really good game.
Oh yeah, that was a good game.
I mean, it's unfortunate about the Patriots won, but on the silver lining part, because I do these randomizer square things that you pay for and you hope to win money out of it. I did hit the main jackpot of $200, which
because
is nice.
Because the Patriots won.
Yeah, because the Patriots won. But because of a certain score, though.
Yeah.
But what I went ahead and did was I went out and picked up Neo.
Yeah.
And I pre-ordered and paid off Horizon.
Yeah.
So, you know, with my winnings, and had a little bit left over to, we'll see what I want to do with it. But, yeah. Yeah. So congratulations, Tom Brady. Number 5.
I mean, you got to give it up. I mean, you may hate the team, but you have to respect.
I do. That was very tremendous. It was funny as fuck, though. Okay, so I saw a bunch of videos, right? Like, Super Bowl was rigged. Look at this. They had this little thing at the bottom of the screen that says Patriots win with touchdown. What they're implying is that in overtime rules, if a touchdown is scored, Patriots would win because they had possession of
it.
If they were to kick a field goal, they don't win automatically.
Yeah.
But if the Falcons fail to score, they would then automatically win. If the if the Falcons got a field goal, they would then pay the next team to score would win, and if Falcons got a touchdown, they would win. Is all it was. It should have been worded, Patriots will win with touchdown. It was just a minor. It just said Patriots win with touchdown, and that's what it was implying. It was so funny. Everybody losing their shit. It's rigged because look, Patriots win with a touchdown. The score's still 28-28, and there's still a lot of time left.
Come on, guys.
They met will win, so it wasn't rigged. At least I hope it wasn't for all I know. But I don't see, man. 97 was sacking the shit out of Tom Brady all night.
Yeah,
so I don't think that screams rigged when Tom Brady's eating grass all night.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Oh, but in other news as well, one of my favorite cartoons is coming back. For the fifth and final season, finally.
Oh, yeah.
Samurai Jack, dude.
Woo, Samurai Jack.
Yeah, March 11th. Yeah, and it looks real good. It looks like it's going to take a real darker turn. I mean, the ones before that, they had some dark times, but this is going to be really good, and I cannot wait. And a lot of people, I don't know if a lot of people used to watch Samurai Jack. I mean, I think it's like a cult classic, I think. You know, along the lines of Courage the Cowardly Dog and all that, because it was around that time. But man, Mike Lazo is a fucking genius, and I can't wait for Samurai Jack. It's the final season. That's it. But can't wait. Phil Lamar, I don't know what you've been doing for this past couple of years, because Mad TV is no longer in. Is no longer on, but I can't wait to hear your voice and see some cool samurai moves.
In other news, too.
Wow!
I'm just now learning that's like getting me mad, kind of. I mean, I understand. I respect video game delays. It sucks when they're delayed, then delayed, then delayed again. But it looks like the Fractured Butthole for South Park is being delayed to just sometime this year.
Yeah, well, I mean, Ubisoft, I really didn't expect.
Well, I know. I also think, like, Trey Parker and Matt Stone have a lot to do with some of the delays, reasonably, with, it's not quite funny, because I know that the Stick of Truth was also significantly delayed.
Mm-hmm.
It was kind of the similar thing. It was expected to release in December 2013, and then it got pushed to March 2013.
Yeah.
And it was kind of a similar case with this. This was supposed to come out December last year, and it got delayed until March. And now it's getting delayed again to just sometime within this fiscal year. So, that sucks. I mean, that's okay, though. I'm glad that the Stick of Truth got delayed, because I'm sure something was probably seriously wrong with it that caused such a significant delay. It wasn't funny, a joke didn't work, or a game mechanic was just not ready, so they took the extra time, but it seems like they need even more time.
Yeah. Well, you know. You know. I didn't really expect it to anything Ubisoft's behind. I always
I'm starting to lose a lot of respect for that. I
think it's
going to
be 2 years later than what they. Because they always do that. They come out at E3 and they're like, look at this, look at that. And I'm just like, sure, okay, we'll see.
But I'm still
4 years later.
I'm still looking forward to Ghost Recon, which hopefully you'll be purchasing as well. And we'll do some co-op videos.
I'll buy it.
I'm looking forward to it. It looks fun. I've watched some gameplay. It looks really cool.
Yeah.
I'm all about third-person shooters, so it's cool. What other news or things?
I don't know how true this is, but my friend yesterday told me that NBA Live or whatever is going to be doing its own league, a 5 month long basketball league, that instead of drafting players, you draft people who play NBA Live and they form their own team, and you go through a season of basketball, but instead of watching the actual Steph Curry, you just watch some guy playing Steph Curry.
Wait, what?
Yeah. I heard it yesterday.
So just some sort of NBA Live league sort of thing.
Yeah, so like it's like the NBA, but instead of actual NBA players, it's like...
Well, I mean, obviously, like, NBA is still going to be going on, though, right? Yeah, obviously.
Oh, well, yeah, of course.
Okay.
Yeah, but it's going to be running like an NBA league.
Is this going to be like a Twitch thing, or...?
Possibly. I mean, I don't know. I was just so, like, taken aback by it that I didn't know what to think. But we're looking for news in that coming up in the next month. So we'll see how.
I guess it's another way of gamers making money. It's like, yeah. I hear a lot of the MLG shit and people making money off it, and that's cool.
Yeah. So we'll see.
Yeah, that's. I don't see anything else news related. I mean, obviously, like the Super Bowl Super Bowl commercials were hit or miss for me. There were some really funny ones.
Yeah.
Like the Kia commercial was great with what's her face?
Kia commercial?
What's her face? She was in. She was on the Ghostbusters. Damn it, McCarthy is that?
Oh yeah, yeah, that was pretty funny. Yeah,
that was pretty good. But obviously, we got to see some like new movie trailers and things like that. But also like Stranger Things 2.
Yeah, that was awesome.
There's a lot of cool things I think coming down with all that. That's all I got for all that.
Yeah, I mean that's all that's been happening.
So. Before I get into like my why the fuck rant, and I'm not gonna try to sound like a bitch here, but man, I had like a bad day the other day.
Why?
Do you ever have one of those days where it seems like everybody's getting in your fucking way?
All the time.
This one was really bad, and I mean it is first world problem city, but okay. I'll explain to you what happened. All right, and I'm just trying to think of a good way to start this without. Sounding like a complete bitch because it was just one of those things. So, you know, I stayed about 45 minutes after work, which is whatever. And I get off. It's a little after 6 o'clock, and I'm thinking to myself like, yeah, I'm gonna go get Neo.
Yeah.
And then I'm gonna go home and play Neo.
Yeah.
It's kind of the goal.
Yeah.
So I get to GameStop because I had a coupon for GameStop and. I fucking loathe GameStop sometimes.
Yeah.
Now, the cashier there was really nice. I get there, and it was funny, because like, she's like walking the floor. There's only one GameStop employee there. And she's like, hey, what brings you in? And I'm just like, well, I was curious if you had a copy of Neo. I'm so sorry I didn't get a chance to pre-order. I've been so busy. She's like, that's okay. I actually have one extra copy. I'm like, great, I'll take it. And it was just me and her in the store.
Yeah.
And as she gets up to go... do her due diligence, a guy walks, like, storms in and says, all right, I'm back. And she's like, oh, I'm really sorry. I'll get your Neo here in just a sec. I was actually helping him. He left the store for a moment. He was coming back. I was like, okay. Oh, no worries. Take care of him. And he was already in the process of, I guess, trading in a bunch of things. And then out comes this backpack full of even more things that he's trading in. A lot of things.
Is this for the Nintendo Switch or something?
Yep, you got it. Okay. It was basically paying off the Nintendo Switch.
Okay.
And it took about, I want to say, almost just short of 20 minutes before I was able to
get GameStop. Oh, my God.
Because he had so much stuff in his bag. And she of course, has to, like, check the discs.
Yeah.
After she checks them out, she's like, I'm so sorry.
I don't think she realized that he had all that.
I didn't think he would have that much stuff, you know, and... I had to check it all, and I'm like, no, it's okay. It's not your fault. You know, he's like, yeah, because the thing is, I already had the stuff he brought in earlier in my system, and they don't like it when we cancel these orders.
Yeah.
I was going to anyways to get you out of the store, but I didn't think it'd take that long. Yeah. Like, no sweat. You're good. So I got my Neo, used my coupon. All right, time to get out. And so I go to get it, and the way the parking lot is, it was completely packed. Mm. I go to get in my truck, and this guy is like... kind of like this shitty looking Honda Civic starts honking at me like
for what?
Because he wants me to move so he can park.
Are you serious?
And I'm like, and the thing is, I got the last copy of Neo, so I'm like checking the disc real quick to make sure. And I put it back, and I realized I didn't think he was honking at me first. Then until he like laid on his horn, like just burn, like
no, I would not have moved.
And I'm like, and I start throwing on my hands, like, dude, what the fuck? And he's like throwing out his horns, like, get the fuck out of the way. And I'm just like,
no,
fuck you. Fuck I gave him a
I
bird.
I would have gotten.
He gave me a bird truck. Right back, and I'm just like, whatever. And he like screeched his tires out.
Fuck
and
you. Then I would have gotten a sandwich at Subway.
As I get into my truck, and I go to pull out. He comes back and nearly hits me.
Ooh.
So I pull back into the spot and throw it in the park, and I stand outside for a second, like, we're gonna play this game. He starts honking his horn out, and I just start shaking my head, and he eventually leaves, so I leave.
Good.
You know, so it was, I don't like to start shit, but you know, it was a very passive aggressive fight. I was hoping he'd get out of his car so I can have some good words with him, but
fuck you.
He didn't. He was a pussy in his little, like, really shitty Honda Civic and just such a rush. And, I mean, it's not my fault the parking lot's full, and it's not my fault you're being a complete dickhead. And I'm not one to just roll over for you. I'm sure you can go home and beat your wife and roll over for you.
Oh, God.
I'm not that person, and I'm not going to be, so fuck you. So, anyways, I leave GameStop after, like, what the fuck? And I just notice my gas light's on. Okay, whatever. And I go, the gas station right next to it is BP. I hate fucking BP, but whatever, I'll fucking do it. And, like, they had, like, 4 or 5 pumps that weren't working, and all the other pumps were full. And I'm like, ah, shit. So I'm, like, doing circles, and I'm trying to think, is there any other gas stations nearby? There really isn't. So I just park up behind somebody on a broken pump and just put it in park and wait for it to clear out. You know, eventually clears out after about 5 or 6 minutes, and, I go to pull into a pump. I got cut off, but whatever. I still got a pump that was free. So I go inside, and there's 2 people in front of me because I was paying cash.
Mm-hmm.
And the person in front of me is asking them to read the back of the numbers to the fucking lotto, scratch-off lotto
tickets. Oh, my God. I hate when they do that shit. And like, it fucking matters.
Yeah, really? You know, like, I don't know the trick, but I don't think
by
there really
doing
is.
That yet?
I'm sure he probably has, and then he won probably once or twice doing that. Now he thinks it's, like, fucking tried and true or some shit.
My God.
So I've never done enough research into it, and I don't think it completely matters. So after he proceeds to take his fucking time doing it, I'm sighing to myself at this point, like, fucking The guy in front of me then has one of those little bubble sheets where his fucking lotto tickets,
God.
And he has like 3 of them that are completely full out. And of course, the machine's taking forever. And the guy's just standing there, and there's only 1 attendant. I was like, fuck me. And it finally spits out his tickets, and then he proceeds to be like, yo, want the number 3, the number 24. You know, he starts fucking getting all these scratch off tickets. I'm like, fuck me. Whatever. So he finally gets his shit, and he hesitates to get the fuck out of the way. All it took, though, was a cashier to make eye contact with me. I was like, 10 on 2. And I fucking threw the money at him. And it was funny, because, like, the guy then started to walk away, and I completely, like, walked in front of him, because, like, dude, you're taking too much time, man. And, of course, like, a line's now forming because of these 2 fucking knuckleheads with their lotto, man. I fucking hate the lottery.
I know.
Sometimes. Like, dude, I mean, play for fun, but, man, these people, and it's always the older people that know, like, I know my time's almost up. I got to get rich real quick. And this is the only way I can possibly do it. And fuck you. So, all right, whatever. And I get a text. The sound engineer's at the house trying to do some dishes and cook.
Mm-hmm.
And says, I'm out of dish soap. And I'm already, like, about to get on I-4. Like, fuck. So I got off in Sanford, went to Target. I was like, oh, you know, I need cat food anyways. And I got stuck. There was only, like, 2 cashiers open. One had a decent line. I got stuck in another. And this old lady's fucking paying with a check.
Oh, God.
Like, God damn, could the day just be over with?
Oh,
like,
my God.
Again, first world city. But, dude, I got off of work around 6 o'clock. I didn't get home until 8. All I did was go get Neo, get some gas and some dish soap, essentially. And it took me over 2 hours to fucking do that. Like, God damn it. Like, oh, man, I was, and even the sun, he was like, what's wrong with you? And I'm just like, oh.
It's a bad day.
It's just bad. It was like, everybody's getting in my way. But that's not my rant. It was it wasn't anybody's direct fault. And I couldn't be mad at one person. I mean, yeah, sure, the lotto guys, whatever. As well as the dude getting, like basically blaring his horn.
Oh, God, yeah,
being
dude,
a douchebag. It was just one of those things where enough little things, like, happened to where it just piled up on me where I was just, like, mad. I wasn't, like, angry at anybody in particular. It was just like, I'm done with today. And then the sad thing is I didn't get a chance to play my fucking game that night because I was so fucking stressed. Well, not just because of that. I had to work on the videos and other things like that. It just was one of those things where if I were to have gotten home at a reasonable time, I probably would have been able to do it. But anyways, no big deal. My rant, though. I just hate days like that. But anyways, my rant though is just why Wired's Why the Fuck is based on why the fuck do people speed in parking lots?
Well, I don't know.
It pisses me off. I know you little guy fucking ran over by some douchebag coworker.
I did.
It happens at my job all the time, but I also notice it when I go to other, like, shopping centers, assholes screeching the fucking tires and hauling ass in parking lots.
Yeah, I don't get that. What is
you need to chill the fuck out, people. You're going to hit a kid or some shit or an old lady or even just anybody for that fucking matter. And guess what? You're going to fucking jail for a while.
It's your fault.
Because it's vehicular manslaughter where you're fucking doing you're speeding in a fucking place where you shouldn't be. And then if you happen to take their life, you're going to get at least 5 fucking years depending on which state you're at. Don't speed in fucking parking lots.
Is it that important?
Is that much to ask?
Is it that important to get to a parking spot that's all the way across the thing, like
right, or even get the hell out of the parking lot. You don't need to
speed. Yeah, you need speed. Not pressing anyone. Not pressing me. You're just pissing other people off.
Right, and it's a danger. It really is. I don't mean to sound like a fucking grumpy old fuck, but
no.
Like, don't get me wrong. I speed all the time, but you will never find me speeding in like a subdivision or parking lots where there's full of pedestrians. You don't do that. You want to go fucking floor it on your local highway and maybe possibly flip your car? Go have fun.
Yeah, have fun.
But you're not going to end any danger of hitting a pedestrian. And,
did I lock the cat in the bathroom?
I think so. So, yeah, I mean, just this week I've just noticed a lot of people like just hauling ass in the parking lot of my work and just other places in general where I just want to like throw a spike strip underneath their vehicle. Or a hammer through their windshield or something like that. Just chill the fuck out, people. That's all I have to ask. Be just mindful. Even if you don't see a pedestrian, you never know, especially in parking lots of people.
Yeah.
People walk between cars. Like, I went to go park in Target when I was going to get the dish soap, and there was like a lady in my fucking spot that was like pulling into.
Oh god.
That was walking. Like, I didn't see her, but thankfully I don't fucking speed, so where I am playing time to spot. But you've seen people like whip their fucking car around.
Oh
the
yeah.
Spots. If somebody did that with in that situation, would have fucking nailed that lady, and she probably wouldn't have died, but she'd be all fucked up, and now you're sitting there paying her medical bills and dealing with higher interest rates, and as well as like their inconvenience, you know, just being empathetic towards another person where now they got to deal with some sort of injury that they didn't obviously plan on, and it's your fault because you couldn't slow the fuck down a little bit to park your shit or to get where you're going. So again, if you don't want to obey the speed limits, that's fine. Just chill the fuck out in pedestrian heavy areas is my point. Yeah, do you want to tell your story real quick of where you almost got ran over by a coworker?
Oh yeah. This guy's a piece of work. So we all know. We all know, everyone in my friend circle knows.
Scion, yo.
Yeah, this guy with a fucking shitty-ass Scion.
He riced the shit
yeah,
out.
He riced the shit out of it. It's still shitty. he's been constantly told not to speed in the parking lot. Because I think he almost hit one of our managers before that. And he's been constantly told not to do it. And at the poop factory, there's a large parking lot. So it's wide, but you know there are a ton of people who work at the poop factory, so the parking lot is always filled with like people walking, either walking to lunch or you know walking back to the car or going on break. And he fucking was it when you dropped me off?
I think so.
Yeah, so you dropped me off and I start walking towards the poop factory entrance. And then out of nowhere he whips around a corner and then all I see is him, like, in the white of his eyes and his, like, shocked expression at seeing me, even though he had plenty of time to stop. If he was going a normal speed limit, he would have had plenty of time to stop. But he comes, like, it looked like inches was probably, like, maybe a foot away. I can't even remember.
It was really close, though.
It was really close. And he, like, slams on his brakes before hitting me. And we just stare at each other. And I know the look that I have on my face could kill puppies. I know the look that I have on my face could kill puppies. And he was like, yo, Sash, sorry. And I was like, fuck you. Like, I lost my mind on him. Like, you piece of shit fucking car. And I think he thought I was joking, but it really wasn't, because I went and reported him to the security guard. Not the security guard that's like like not the bald guy, but like the head of security, and
the guy that's actually gonna do something
about it. And he got in a lot of trouble. He got written up. He almost got fired. And they told him if he did it again, he would get fired. Did you know that he came and worked at the after I left the poop factory when I went to go work at that payroll company?
Uh-huh.
He came to work at that payroll company. And almost hit someone in that parking lot too.
It did,
and they wrote him up 3 times for it, and said one more time, and he's done.
Yeah,
and no, he did it, and he got fired.
Oh, he got fired.
He got fired.
Oh,
yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, because nice. He sped through the parking lot. I think he had like a knee. No, he still had that shin sign on. Yeah, and he almost hit someone.
I learned of somebody else getting fired too from that payroll company this week. I'll tell you about it more. It's more of a. I mean, you probably barely know the guy, but I know him. Okay. But anyways, so I think that's about going to do it for this.
Oh, yeah. Yeah,
for this podcast.
Yeah.
So, yeah, be safe out there, people. Don't fucking run people over. And,
yeah.
And I guess in my other rant previous, just, I don't know, don't play the lottery.
Yeah.
And just be mindful of other people's time. Again, I don't know. Fuck it.
Yeah, who cares? Yeah, whatever.
All right. Well, hope you guys enjoyed this. Again, like and subscribe if you wanted to see more of these. And
yep.
If you guys want to hear us talk about something or rant about something, let us know.
Yeah.
And tell us your story about maybe almost getting hit by a car or even maybe when you did get hit by a car.
Yeah. Hopefully you're still alive.
Yeah. Bye.
Bye.